And my engineers were done. It's 10 o'clock in the morning. They must have worked all night. So I had an invitation that came at 3 o'clock in the morning from Heidi's business manager to go meet her. Well, guess what? God must have wanted me to meet Heidi because my schedule just opened. It just flat out opened. Does my schedule open often, Sarah?
That never happens.
Never. So, I know that Heidi's important. I better go see this woman. I've never met her before. My schedule opened, a two-hour window turned out to a four-hour window, right, Heidi? And I went to go meet her at a hotel that's right there in South Austin, I'm sorry. And Heidi had a seat set up right next to her for me. I've never met her. And she had a seat right next to her. She has all these very important people, but she had a seat for me. How did she even know it was coming? I never called. I just showed up. And there was one seat, Heidi. And so she asked me a question. What can I do to help you? This is what it's all about, you guys. The king-prophet relationship. I've run some incredible technologies. I've seen them grow. And here's a woman that asked how she could help me. I was actually there to figure out how to help her. And that became mutual that day. So here's what I said. Can you help me with some of these kings? Can you help me, like, shake them up a little bit? And she said, what does that mean? And I said, I went to Africa one time, and a guy got shaken up, and he found Jesus in 3 days, and it shook up one of the largest companies in the world. So let's shake some kings. And Heidi, we've had a few kings down there, right? They've been shaken. Heidi uses the word wrecked. I don't use it often. If you drive really fast cars, you don't use wrecked often. So let's do this. This is a working session, okay? Listen, it's a working session. So I decided, since you just saw me with a bunch of cowboys and trucks, I brought back some way to shake some of these kings. So Heidi, I literally brought you a rope to snag them and a hat for the kings. So you know who you are. So here we go. The only one here that's pink is Heidi. This is for you. Come on up. And the pink thing. Come on, baby. Now guys, this is to kind of lasso him up. You see it? So Heidi is going to help me, especially today, for the...
Because I love you.
Hopefully she doesn't put that on my neck. The point is this. Isn't it cool? I meet her the first time and she asks, how can I help you? She didn't ask me for money. She never asked me for a penny, ever. She's never asked me for a donation. So I can trust her to meet kings. Yes. And like we heard from the speaker yesterday, Bruno, right? You don't have to ask. If you have to ask, that's a problem. Yeah. Money will chase you, yeah. All right? Yeah. So thank you for helping me rope some kings and shake them up. I do have other gifts here because some other ropers in here. But Heidi gets the first one. This is hers. You take it back. Unless, is that allowed in the airport? Can we get that through? Now guys, do you understand Heidi is clearly being used by God? Yeah. For me to partner up and spend time with her and see these CEOs get wrecked is all part of what she's wearing. Thank you, Heidi. Thank you. Wait. There's more. Okay, come on, Adam. Come on, let's go, baby. Yeah, I already know what Hattie wants. Well, Adam, go ahead. Yeah, but don't take the black one. That's the one. That was Adam's. And his rope is the blue one. So, Adam, I'm doing this intentionally, guys. I'm in the cattle business. I'm in the sheep business. I'm in livestock. Adam has helped me rope some kings, haven't you? We're roping some right now. We're roping right now. So Adam, thank you for all your years of helping me. Thank you. There's more here. So I know not all the speakers here, but I've got them all kind of set up here. So Lance is from Texas, so he doesn't want the Yeti hat, and he doesn't want, these are awesome hats, by the way. He does, this one actually is for Jonathan. He wants the one that has, there it is, the, where the hat came from. He wants Wheelers from Bernie, Texas. Because Bernie's in the middle of nowhere. This is where I live. So for Lance, when he's, when we see him again, if we do, this is his hat, okay? And there's his rope. He's roping kings, all right? Jonathan. Where's Jonathan? Come on. Jonathan, the black hat. Here we go. The reason I'm doing this, guys, is to be sure you understand. I prepared an entire presentation based on David. And so Jonathan picks me up at the airport. But the individual who was supposed to pick me up was Samuel. So Jonathan and Samuel present themselves in Singapore here to a message I prepared for David. You see it? This is it, the Yemi hat, right? And an orange one. Rope and canes, baby. Okay, we're not done. There's a pastor here. Come on. Come on, pastor. We've got to take it. This is for you and your wife. Both Yeti, both on the same path, same color. And they have a rope. You only get one rope. You have to pick the color. I didn't know which your wife would like. The orange here or the red?
The red.
Yes, okay. Thank you, Pastor. Now, the reason I'm doing this is to be sure you understand something. Kind of break it up a little bit. I'm not designed to be in this business. This is where God took me. I never planned on being in the cattle business. But as of last night, I promise you, I'm in the cattle and sheep business. Would you say? The best and the biggest in the world, the fastest growing company on the planet. And God did that. So, this one, obviously, my wife's not going to wear a hat, but Tisha, would you please take this home so Christian can have it? It's my son, the next roper. Okay, so the rest of these are for the speakers. I have them all here. We can just leave them. This is for all the speakers on roping hats. All right, thank you guys. Okay, so let's go through these slides again, and we'll do a workshop on this. I have control, right? Here we go. Zechariah 9:12. Are you all with me?
Yes.
Chained to hope. Now, why am I saying this? Because this is what a king would have. The ability to hope. What does he hope for? What does she hope for? Well, they hope their company makes it. They hope they can make payroll. They hope their products are attractive. They hope their price point is right online. They hope the timing of the market is ready to receive it. They may have a lot of hope. Kings need hope. So how do they find it? Well, they can only find it through Jesus. He's the hope, right? The hope of glory. He is the hope. How does a king find hope? They got to get Jesus. We got to rope some kings, you guys. So I'm sharing this so you understand this is all being set up so you can figure out how to build your company, design it. So let's go through that for a second. You heard a testimony from Gabe. He talked about a business deal that we're praying for. That's not a bad company. Before I do a business deal, pray. You heard it live from him. Then something switched because the Lord wanted something for him because he was there praying with me. He doesn't work for my company. I don't need software engineers. I have a whole bunch. I have 300. So the point is I don't need another software engineer, but the Lord knew what he needed and the prayer switched. And this is what the Lord told me. While we were praying, God has a position for you now. And when we said amen, at the exact time, the phone rang. And his job came. At the exact time. Now guys, remember this. Why would God delay a king? Why would he not allow a king to come to earth? The king did come to earth at the exact time. Everything was right. The Romans had built the roads. There was order And he could now see from heaven, God, that his son coming in would have the ability now to propagate. You with me?
Yeah.
Hope. So, is he stopped? No. But well, where are the kings? Where are the kings? Now, guys, I'm sharing this right now. They're here. They're in this audience. I don't know in my walk who's not working or doesn't have a job. And that's a king. I don't know in my walk who doesn't have a family that's trying to make payroll, in a sense, make sure the groceries are paid for, make sure the house payments are being made. That's a king. Do you see what I'm saying? Managing finances and knowing what you need is in the realm of the heavens. So you have to learn how to pray, and we'll teach you that today, okay? He got the job. Praise God. What's happening inside? It's this song. Let's look at that really quickly. Next slide, perfect. Let me do this so I can see it. This is a song that Katie wrote for her husband. I've looked in your eyes 10,000 times, I'm barely breathing. It's pretty interesting, huh? Look at the next one. I have traveled around the world and seen some different places. My place is beside you. Look at the lyrics. She writes it for her future husband, and it's all about our relationship with God. Do you see it? And then it just keeps on going. It's always been you. Now that's us to God. It's always been you. You with me? This is the moment that our stories have led up to. Are you with me, guys? When that convergence happens, which Stacy talked about yesterday, it's like fusion. That's the moment. Is that today? Is that today for some of you? Nothing could ever come between us. Look at that. What was always meant to be true. Why would God leave you? Why did he forsake you? Why is he not blessing kings? Maybe they're not listening. Look at the end of this sermon. It's a great story. Short song. 2 minutes. I'll always love you. I'll always love you. I'll always love you. I'll always love you. This is running parallel to this going on in my office. She's writing a song while her new future husband is being prayed for, and God gives him the job of his dream and the wife that he's been praying for, and she's writing this love story, which I'm using today in Singapore. Put that together. That's the couple you just see, and that's you guys. So that relationship is under God. Working to help, pray for me. And God took care of them. See it? So do kings need prayer? I think so. Kings are always loved, regardless of what anybody says. It says in Revelation chapter 1, verse 5, Jesus Christ, the ruler over the kings, right? To him who loved us and washed us from our sins in his own blood. And make sure you see that. To him who loved us. This is actually kings. So if kings don't feel loved by the church, the community of believers, how do you reach them? Do you judge them? I don't think so. Because if God loves them and loves us the same, that's how we're going to reach these kings. That's what Heidi does. She just loves on them. They may say things. I can probably think of some. This isn't what I was thinking when I came, Heidi. I'm going to really sleep in a tent. Where's the 5-star hotel? She doesn't think about that. She just loves on them. But she's not just someone that loves kings. She loves those that are not kings and are from the most remote areas of the world, and they have nothing. Interesting. They have love. And when these kings come and see that, Heidi's playing the role of showing the love of God to both. And that's the relationship. That's what kings need. Because when they see that, they become givers. They see it. It's real. That's the body. And that's what Heidi represented when I first met her. And God wanted me to see that. Because I hadn't felt that. Well, when I came to her place and she said, how can I help you? I'm thinking, are you kidding? I mean, I need to be helping you. And she said, nope, I'm going to help you. We're trying to figure out how to help each other. This is a really good relationship. She's not wanting something from me. She wants something for me. Yeah. See, honey? Yeah. So if you know someone that's prophetic and they want something for you, that's a good one. Yeah. If they're always taking from you, I guess that's up to you to decide. Look for those that give.
Yeah.
Look for those that are willing to try and help no matter what. And that's why I'm glad you're here, honey. Thank you for coming. I wrote this knowing she would be here. That's what she represents. I'm sure that's why her ministry is it's exploding all over the world. Look at this. Look at that beautiful woman. I just put this picture in right now in the back corner. That's my wife. And that's Washington, D.C. at the inauguration with Adam. And oh, there's Andrew at the top. And that bodybuilder woman who I'm afraid to flex with. Look at those arms. Oh my gosh, Andrew. Oh, anyway, I just entered this picture. Look at Tisha down there in the corner. This is my wife, Tisha, but she's down the corner right here. This is Singapore. Where do you think she's having more fun? Maybe you could tell me, Tish. Where did she have more fun? She loves it here. There we go. So she's in Washington, wearing a beautiful dress. She never told me the price. It's okay. That tuxedo was put on me, so that one, I never told her the price. The point is this, it doesn't really matter. We went to reach Kings, and then somebody reached out to me, and that was Andrew. Andrew said, come and speak in Singapore. And I was like, oh my gosh, I remember someone else inviting me to Singapore. And I'm thinking of my schedule, and I probably could look out at Sarah and thinking, oh my gosh, how's this going to happen, Lord? Oh, shoot. Wait a minute. I'm supposed to be in Singapore for a conference. It starts, guys, in 2 days at the Marina Hotel. You with me? I'm already going there. So for Andrew to ask, it was starting to come together. However, I still need a sign. I believe this is important. The Bible says, when God is with you and you're taking the gospel to the ends of the earth, these signs will accompany you. And I don't mind signs because some of the things I'm signing are very risky. So I want a sign. So coming to Singapore is not risky. Ask my wife now. She wants to stay. Because you all know my wife wants to stay in Singapore. But Andrew, I didn't know him. And I had texted Heidi. And I can't always get a hold of you, Heidi, just so you'll know. I'm not sure why. Heidi may be in a Jeep somewhere, guys, where there's no cell coverage. That's not happening in Singapore. Here's what I'm going to say. The Lord has validated this meeting, without a doubt. Because when I thought about Andrew, which was months later, immediately, my phone rang. And a prophet friend of mine tells me, on the phone, for no reason, just says it. I'm supposed to call you because there's a man named Andrew from Singapore. And she hangs the phone up. So Andrew, that's how it works, right? So I knew I was supposed to be here. I'm flying right now anyway because I had a great meeting last night with a fabulous corporation. And if I would not have come to the church, I would have missed the meeting that God has already set up for me. It's pretty cool, Andrew, isn't it? Again, kings need to be loved. Kings need to know that they're relevant. And let's do this. We have to make sure that God is telling you this right now. Is David loved? Was David loved? Remember the scripture from my first speaking engagement? This is in Acts. So Paul's writing this. I have found David, the son of Jesse, a man after my own heart, who will do my will. Now, we hear it all the time, after my own heart. Have you ever heard the second part of that? It's part of the same scripture. Who will do my will. See, what God's looking for from kings is to do God's will. Not their own will. Not easy. Not if you're running the company. Not if you have lots of lawyers. Not easy to know God's will. Right? But that's what God says. He was after, look at God's heart, because he did God's will. Now, he may have messed up, and we can talk about how that happened, but it's not important. What's important is he got back in line with God. He knew that God loved him, and he knew this: if he would just do God's will, then that relationship is restored. That prayer today is going to happen for you businessmen that need to learn how to do God's will. Let's pray that. Now, you're at a service here, so it's much easier. However, not everybody here came to the service. This is why I know I'm supposed to be here. I already got signs, right? Andrew told me. But this happened way before that. This is Whole Foods in Las Vegas. And in line to buy coffee, I am talking to the man with the beard from Mexico, and he wants to know more about how to be a king. And in line at a Whole Foods restaurant, they have these little coffee shops in the front before you go shopping. And I'm talking about what a king should be doing, which is God's will, and that kings are loved, and that kings should love God also. Those are the three pieces. While I'm there, the lady in the white shirt is standing behind me listening, but I'm talking too long. This happens. All right, Sarah, don't say it, Heidi. So, I feel so bad. I buy her coffee. The lady in the white shirt, I don't even know who she is. This is Whole Foods in Las Vegas. I don't live in Las Vegas. Believe me, guys. I was there for a convention, and then I actually was in Reno, and I met with Heidi, and in a private plane, and I'm in Vegas. I'm not even sure what's happening. My schedule's pretty wild, but I'm here, and I'm just buying coffee, and that gentleman there from Mexico wants to know how to be a king. So while I'm sharing that, the woman in the white is listening, so I decide to buy her coffee, and then this is what she says to me: "Will you pray for all of my friends?" I go, "Who's your friends?" "We're all from Singapore." So, there they are. Now listen, we were able to get a confirmation from God that Andrew was okay, right? But what about all these individuals? We tried everything. I don't have Facebook. My lawyers don't let me be on social media. I have lots of lawyers. And the point is this: the individuals here, we're having a hard time finding them because I don't live in Singapore. So, when I got to the church, just you'll know, you guys with me? If you're making a lot of money and you don't do God's will, this isn't a good feeling. I'm not going to miss these individuals. I will not. So I asked for help from God. And then there's this beautiful young lady that's back in the back helping us with lunch. And she says, "What do you need help with?" And I said, "I need to find," and I put this picture in front of her. "I need those people to come to this conference. And we'll just, whatever we need to do to get them in." And she goes, "Okay, I'll take it from there." And she asks this gentleman, Patrick. Come on, Patrick. I guess bring me a hat. I need a hat. Yes. Patrick is on the internet, which is what happens in Singapore a lot. So he's roping some of those people. Where are they? Where is the people from Las Vegas? Stand up. Just stand up. Look, they're here. He did it. This is important. You guys see this. I'm setting up how you do business God's way. You connect with a great community. And the community connects with your heart. Patrick finds these individuals from this picture. And they're here today. Thank you so much. So this is my reason for sharing all this. Y'all are wondering what in the world? How in the heck is this happening? What's happening? Look at what it says. David cares about God's people. So as long as I keep caring, trying, pushing, without sleep for days, like 3 days without sleep, to pray for people and assure that I want to do God's will, he watches over my company. He watches over my company and he grows the company. And that's what kings need to hear. Well, I meet with kings that are very wealthy and I say, God's going to grow your company. They say to me, my company's pretty big. I say, well, it's not big enough because you're not fulfilled. You don't have God. And if you think you're God, you're in real trouble. Because once you go to heaven, if you think you are, guess what you're going to find out? Without God, there is no heaven. None. But with God, heaven begins today. See it? So, it says in this scripture here, for who is this uncircumcised Philistine that he should defy the armies of the living God? Who's speaking this? David. David is talking to, basically, across a valley, Goliath. David, if you read these scriptures, has just been picked on by his own brothers. Has that happened? Happens to me all the time. They're jealous of him. Does it happen? Happens to me all the time. By my own brothers. By my own fellow Christians. They're jealous. So they pick on David. And David's like, who are these, whatever, look at this. These beings, which is this Goliath character across the valley, who's screaming at him. And David, rather than think about what just happened three scriptures before, his own brothers picking on him, he basically defends the armies of the living God. His own brothers he defends. And that's what I do. No matter how much I'm picked on, no matter how jealous the church becomes or makes fun of my cars or my wife, it doesn't matter. I still defend them. And that's David. Look at it. In 1736, 10 scriptures later, he's before Saul. And he says the same thing. Who is this character? See, he's defiled the armies of the living God, even in front of a king, David, another king. He's saying, why is this character coming after the people of God? And when a king gets a hold of this and recognizes that, then they start helping, filling places like this. Now, I did tell Andrew this. I wish this conference was after the one I'm going to, because this would be filled with non-believers. That's what I do. But because it's before, I guess I've learned my lesson. Start setting up conferences with you, Andrew, Pastor, you, and let's do it after big, giant IoT conferences. And then I can make this work a different way. Let's bring in those who don't know God, kings, and tell them that we love them, and tell them that we care about them, and we don't get afraid of their cars. We don't make fun of people who have vehicles. If you're going to chase kings, get a car that you can catch them with. I have to say this. Here's what I'm chasing next. Google. Will it be a good chase?
Yeah.
Yes, it will. Now, we expected them to be here, but my meeting with Google is actually backwards. It's later. That's okay. The next time, whenever, Pastor, you have me back, those people, with the help of Patrick, and social media, we're going to bring everybody here from that picture. Okay? Can we do that? And don't give up. I am having dinner or lunch with the woman right under the yellow O you see there. U.S. Ambassador, right, to Singapore. I have lunch with her shortly.
Wow.
Right? So this is important. You guys know that. She's there with Google, and I can invite her to the next, whatever we're going to do, whatever it's going to be, August 2018, I guess, December. Anyway, I'm sharing this right now. Let's get some kings involved and how they can be used by God. I will be one of them that will help lead this cause. I just did it with Patrick, and Las Vegas, Singapore is here tonight. You see it? It works. This is the most important part. Do kings love God? Does David love God? Oh my gosh. Look at Psalms 119. And I will be delighted in myself in your commandments, which I love. Can you find a king that loves God's commandments? Not many, but we could get them there because if they realized that God would bless their company, take care of those employees, and help build a major organization in a most unique way, meaning it's God doing it and not man, they will start to love God's commandments. It's just going to happen. Look at 48. My hands I will lift up. They'll begin to worship God because they see God do great things. Last night, God did an amazing, amazing miracle. So, Sarah, you have to come up. I've got to have your help. Do we have another mic? So I can only say certain things, and she knows that. But let's try. Come up, Sarah. Here's a stool. Sarah is 32 years old and one of the most talented business leaders I've ever met in my life. And she just got full of the Holy Spirit just recently, am I right? So if I'm going to have leaders in my company, they have to be full of the Holy Spirit, Andrew. They got to be full of the Holy Spirit.
A job requirement.
It's a requirement. Isn't that interesting? In my company, I've never looked at a resume. Never. Never. God brings every single person right on time. So, let's do this quickly because we need to be sure we can get to you guys on your dreams. Last night, we had a meeting with a very large corporation. I can say the name, can I? We can say Microsoft, okay? If I were not in this church, Andrew, if I had not come, I would have missed the meeting. Microsoft could only meet with me last night. Remember, Andrew, I said I'm not sure I could make it because I have to go to all these major meetings with these big data companies who are chasing us, which I love the chase, right? Because they're all going to get saved. All of them. So Microsoft doesn't respond. We don't have a response. But what's wrong with that picture? God was waiting to see, am I going to make a decision to come and serve this church with this great pastor and all the other pastors and those that serve here? God was waiting to see if I would do that, and I did. And I got some signs, but I stayed with it. I believed, because signs are not necessarily enough. You still have to have faith. Have to. It's not quite enough, but they're getting better, these signs. You know, like Heidi having an extra chair for me. I think that's a sign. But here's the point. When I was with Sarah, and we both go to this meeting, my wife went, we were sitting there, I described my product technology with that commercial, which just came out and is not even done yet, just sitting on my phone. And when we showed it to Microsoft, it was the exact answer they needed right now. Exactly. They've been searching for it. And I just did the commercial.